22 मार्च 2021 मॉर्निंग मुरली ओम शांति बाप दादा मधुबन स्वीट चिल्ड्रन द फादर लव्स नॉलेजेबल सोल्स देयरफॉर बिकेम मास्टर ओशियंस ऑफ नॉलेज द सेम एज द फादर क्वेश्चन व्हाट डज द फादर रिमाइंड यू चिल्ड्रन अबाउट इन दिस बेनेवोलेंट एज आंसर चिल्ड्रन इट हैज नाउ बीन 5000 ईयर्स Since you left your home. In 5000 years, you have taken 84 births and this is now your last birth. It is your stage of retirement. Therefore, now make preparations to return home. You will then go to the land of happiness. You may leave at home with your families but become pure for this last birth and remember the father. Song. The flame has ignited in the gathering of moths. Om Shanti, you children have understood that God is one. God is one. The Father of all souls is one. He is called the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, the Creator of the world is one. There cannot be many according to this principle. Human beings cannot call themselves God. You have now become instruments for godly service. God is establishing the new world which is called the Golden Age. You are becoming worthy of that. No one is impure in the Golden Age. You are now becoming pure. He says, I am the purifier and I give you children elevated directions. Remember me. Your incorporeal father and you will become pure and satupradhan from impure and tamupradhan. Your sins will be absorbed with the fire of yoga of remembrance. Sages and holy men say that God is omnipresent. On the one hand, they say that God is one and then here in this world, there are many who call themselves God. They call themselves Shri Shri Jagat Guru 108. The Guru of the world is only the one Father, the Supreme Soul, the one who purifies the whole world, liberates the whole world from sorrow. Only He is the remover of sorrow and the bestower of happiness. Human beings cannot be called that. Only you children understand this. This is the impure world and all are impure. In the pure world, as are the emperor and empresses, so the subjects. In the golden age, they are worthy of worship, emperors and empresses. Then, on the path of devotion, they become worshippers. When 2 degrees of the emperor and empresses of the golden age are reduced, they are called a king and queen. All of these are detailed matters. Otherwise, there is liberation in life in a second. The father explains, you may leave at home with your families but remain pure for this last birth. It is now your stage of retirement. The land of retirement and the land of peace are the same thing. Souls reside there in the Brahma element which is also called Brahmand. In fact, souls are not egg-shaped. A soul is a star. Baba has explained that all the souls in this drama are actors. Just as actors in a play change into different costumes as they play their different parts, so this too is an unlimited play. From the beginning, souls come onto earth and enter bodies made of the 5 elements and play their parts. The Supreme Soul and Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar are all actors. You are given various costumes to play your parts in a play. At home, all souls are without bodies. Then, when a body of the 5 elements is ready, a soul enters it. A soul takes 84 bodies and so he also has that many names. Souls have just the one name. Shri Baba is the purifier. He doesn't have a body of his own. He has to take the support of a body. He says, my name is Shiva. Although I enter an old body, The name of this one's body belongs to him. He has a worldly name and he is then given a spiritual name. When someone converts from one religion to another, his name is changed. You too have changed from the Shudra religion and come into the Brahmin religion, and so your names are changed. You write Shubaba through Brahma, the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul. It's Shubaba. His name doesn't change. Through Brahma, Shubaba is now carrying out establishment of the original eternal deity religion, which has disappeared. Those who were pure and worthy of worship became impure and worshippers. You have completed 84 births. The deity religion is now being established once again. It is remembered that the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, comes and carries out establishment again through Brahma. Therefore, Brahmins are definitely needed. Where do Brahma and Brahmins come from? Shivaba comes and adopts you through Brahma. He says, "You belong to me. You are Shivaba's children anyway." And then, through Brahma, you became grandchildren. The father of all people is one. All of these children are Kumars and Kumaris. Shivaba adopts them through Brahma. People don't know that the father comes and establishes the original eternal deity religion. It isn't that new souls come. They show that annihilation took place and that Krishna then came floating in the ocean on a people leaf. They have made up all of those stories. The history and geography of the world continue to repeat. Souls are immortal and the part in each soul is eternal. The part is never erased. In the golden age, there is the Sun Dynasty kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan. It never changes. The world continues to change from new to old and old to new. Each one has received his imperishable part. The father says, on the path of devotion, with whatever failings devotees perform their worship, I grant them visions accordingly. I grant some a vision of Hanuman and others a vision of Ganesh. I fulfill their devotional feelings. This too is fixed in the drama. People then think that God is in everyone. This is why they say that he is omnipresent. There is a rosary of devotees. It is remembered that Narad is the main one among the males and Meera among the females. The rosary of devotees, the rosary of Rudra and the rosary of knowledge are all separate. The rosary of devotees is never worshipped. The rosary of Rudra is worshipped. At the top is the flower, means tassel, and then the dual bead, and then the children who sit on the royal throne. The rosary of Rudra is the rosary of Vishnu. The rosary of devotees is just praise. All of them turn the beads of rosary of Rudra. You are not devotees, but knowledgeable souls. The father says, I love the knowledgeable souls. The father is the ocean of knowledge and is giving you children knowledge. Your rosary is worship. There is worship of the eight jewels. It is because they are knowledgeable souls that they are worshipped. People make a ring to represent this and wear it because of their ones who make Bharat into heaven. They pass with honors and so they are praised. The ninth jewel is Shubaba, placed in the middle. They call that the nine jewels. This is a detailed explanation. The father simply says, remember the father and the inheritance and your sins will be absolved and you will return home. Impure souls cannot go to the pure world. Here all are impure. The bodies of the deities are pure and viceless. They are worthy of worship, as are the king and queen. So the subjects, they are worthy of worship. Here all are worshippers. There is no question of sorrow there. That is called heaven, the land of happiness. There was happiness, wealth and peace. Everything, now there is nothing. This is why this is called hell and that is called heaven. We souls are residents of the land of peace. We come from there to play our parts. we have to take the full 84 births. It is now the land of sorrow, and we will then go to the land of peace, and then to the land of happiness. The Father is inspiring you to make effort to become the masters of the land of happiness and to change from humans into deities. This is your confluence age. The Father says, I come at the confluence age of the cycle, not in every age. I only come once in the cycle at the confluence age in order to change the world. It was the golden age and it is now the iron age, and then the golden age has to come. This is the benevolent confluence age. Everyone has to benefit. Everyone is liberated from the jail of Ravan. He is called the remover of sorrow and the bestower of happiness. Here, all are unhappy. You are making effort to go to the land of happiness. In order to go to the land of happiness, you first have to go to the land of peace. It has now been 5,000 years since you began playing your parts. The Father explains, it has been 5,000 years since you left your home, and in that time, you people of Bharat have taken 84 births. It is now your last birth. It is everyone's stage of retirement. Everyone has to return home. It is remembered that he is the ocean of knowledge, Rudra. This is sacrificial fire of the knowledge of Shiva. Shiv is the purifier. He is also the supreme soul. Devotees have given him the name Rudra. This real name is just Shiv. His real name is just Shiv. So Baba carries out establishment through Prajapita Brahma. There is only one Brahma. This one is impure, and the same Brahma then becomes pure, and so he becomes an angel. The Brahma shown in the subtle region is not a different Brahma. There is only one Brahma. This one is the corporeal one, and that one is the subtle one. When this one becomes completely pure, he will be seen in the subtle region. There are no flesh and bones there. Sri Baba has explained, souls who don't have bodies continue to wander around. They are called ghosts. They continue to wander around until they receive a body. Some of them are good and others are bad. The Father explains everything to you. He is the ocean of knowledge, and he therefore definitely explains knowledge. There is liberation in life in a second. Remember Alpha and Beta, and you will receive the inheritance of liberation in a life in a second. It is so easy. The very name is Easy Raj Yoga. They think that their yoga is the yoga of Bharat. However, that is the hut yoga of sannyasis. Yoga is absolutely easy. Yoga means remembrance. Theirs is hut yoga. This is easy. The Father says, remember me in this way. There is no need to wear a locket, etc. You are children of the Father. Simply remember the Father. You came here to play your parts. You now all have to return home, and you will then come to play those same parts again. It is the people of Bharat who became those of the Sun dynasty, then the Moon dynasty, then the Merchant dynasty, and then the Shudra dynasty. During this time, those of other religions also came. You take 84 births, then you have to claim number 1. When you go to the golden age, everyone else will then be in the land of peace. There isn't a dynasty in other religions. Only in Bharat are there dynasties. You became part of the Sun and Moon dynasties. You are now in the Brahmin clan. You have become the Brahmins who belong to the clan of Brahma. The father sits here and explains all of these things. Those whose intellects are not able to imbibe anything are told to remember the father. By knowing about his father, the son becomes aware of what his property will be. A daughter doesn't receive an inheritance. Here, all of you are the children of the Shiva Baba, and all of you therefore have a right. All of you males and females have a right. Teach everyone how to remember Shiva Baba. The more you remember him, the more your sins will be absolved and the more you will become pure from impure. How can the alloy in the souls be removed? The father says it is only through yoga that the alloy will be removed. These impure bodies have to be shed here. The souls will then become pure. All of you will return like a swarm of mosquitoes. The intellect says that there will be very few people in the golden age. So many people will die in this destruction. Only a few will then remain. There will only be a few kings and 900,000 subjects in the golden age. They sing a song about this. There are 900,000 stars, that its subjects. The tree is small at first and then it grows. Now there are so many souls. The father comes and becomes everyone's guide and takes you all back. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, burn the alloy of sinful actions in the fire of yoga and become pure. It is now your stage of retirement. Therefore, in order to return home, become completely satapradhan. Second point, in this benevolent age, become a remover of sorrow and a bestower of happiness, the same as the father. Blessing, may you be an elevated effort maker who experiences greatness by finishing ordinariness. Explanation, every thought of elevated effort makers would be great because there would automatically be remembrance of the father in their every thought and every breath. Just as on the path of devotion, it is said that every unheard word is heard. The unending chant continues all the time. In the same way, let your effort also be constant. This is called elevated effort. You don't need force to have remembrance, but let there be natural remembrance and ordinariness will then finish and you will continue to develop greatness. This is the sign of moving forward. Slogan, those who go to the bottom of the ocean with churning power claim a right to the jewels. Om Shanti.